Hello everyone, let's start the session. In fact, let's continue our session. A quick recap what we have been doing. We have started discussing supply process, purchasing and supply process, right? So what are under the steps of purchasing process? It is good to divide the whole process into three categories: pre-sourcing, sourcing and post-sourcing. Okay, pre-sourcing are all activities which are carried out within an organization to understand the needs of internal customers, right, and communicate to the right authority in the purchasing department. And you know, then purchasing department can take over from there to identify potential suppliers. Sourcing is once you have set of suppliers and you know you have pool of suppliers, what criteria, what decision making criteria sourcing section can adopt to select suppliers. So once supplier is selected, we sign purchasing order, PO, famously called PO. So we were here. We started with forecast or plan the requirement, right? It depends on whether we are going for annual plan or we are going for the requirement set by the other department or other functions. So we have seen how we can carry out this requisition of need, various types of requisitions which can happen. So if the requisitions are like services, right, service request, or where you know there is little ambiguity on the requirements, there we can have statement of work. So and description of and clarification of need, identification of potential sources. Mind it, most of the activities we would be carrying out in detail in the subsequent section. For example, supplier selection, supplier evaluation, right? What are the different methods to carry out? There can be multi-criteria, there can be multi-objective decision making. That would be discussed in the subsequent sections, subsequent sessions. And we have already discussed about the identification of potential suppliers process, which actually starts with the sending some request for information, request for proposal, request for quotation. So if in general companies are buying routine products, repetitive goods, right, their specifications are clear. So in that case, we go for request for quotations. So if request for quotation means we know what the department want, right? So only thing is we need when they want, right? And what quantity they want, right? The specifications are clear, but we as purchasing managers, we would like to get the quotation so that we can compare the prices. What is request for proposal? Request for information is again just information gathering, right? In case we are going for new product or different products, different specification or very customized product, so then we can ask the suppliers what they have to offer, any new thing to offer or any different part component they can make. And the request for bids we have already seen. So we have, right? So I would show you one a very interesting example of a request for proposal. This is taken from the book by Fraser and other authors. So in this book, you know, we would see that in an hospital setting, there can be variety of requirements. So this is an example of Northeastern Hospital, right, which is the largest acute care teaching hospitals in US. So they are talking about in this case, right, where they have physician, resident and staff number around 15,000. Okay. Now here they have asked for request for proposals, RFPs. For what purpose they want? Recycling and waste transfer services. Predominantly recycling and waste transfer services. Okay, so this is request for proposal. Now we would see that had this been a requirement of some medical equipment where specifications are clear, in that case, we would go for request for quotations, right? But this is a kind of services, right? But along with the services, they need equipment also because it is they're seeking for waste transfer services. Let us see how they write the proposal here, right? Because they want to see what potential bidders or what potential suppliers have to offer differently. Okay, so we will see that how this request for proposals look like. This is proponents are invited to submit proposals for recycling and waste transfer services. So, in the first paragraph, if you can read, they just mentioned what is the spend, you know, this services would incur in the hospital. That means how much spend is dedicated, how much amount is budgeted for this services. And then it is clearly mentioned that whatever they are looking for, under recycling and waste transfer services, they have briefed about that. What is that? Paper, paper products, box board, catalogs, magazines, right? Paper egg carton. So they have specified. So here, the specifications are not very clear. They want the suppliers to offer commingled rigid food, beverage and liquid containers and so on. Now you see here what else is added in the request for a proposal. The successful proponent shall be required to provide the necessary equipment to handle the recycling program, a compactor for paper, 30-yard bins or other suitable transfer systems, right? So now you see here other suitable transfer systems. They are not specifying anything. So, likewise, looking for to suggest and identify alternative methods that would provide greater efficiencies and cost savings. Okay. So, this is how, you know, these days, you know, companies are looking for innovative in a collaborative manner. We would see today that there is something, some strategy called early supply involvement, called ESI, early supply involvement, where it is argued that the early a company involves the supplier, maybe in the design phase or in the prototype phase, better it would be for the effectiveness of purchasing and in fact subsequent processes of designing and production. So request for proposal is one platform where, you know, you can ask for what you need. Even if it is not very clear requirements, you can always mention what are your needs, right? In linguistic terms, it would be good. But give as much detail as possible. And cost saving initiatives that would benefit. The lowest cost proposal or any other proposal may not necessarily be accepted. It's very clear. And that's what make it different from request for quotations. Okay. So request for quotation is you get all the information and you compare different quotations for the price. So what else is there? Is interested in participating with successful proponent in any initiative that are mutually beneficial. So you can see here, it's a win-win situation which this company, this hospital is looking for. And strategic and economic advantages in the areas of administration, health, research or teaching. Bidders should provide an evidence of previous partnering arrangement where they have collaborated or mutually beneficial initiatives with clients. Okay. So we are also interested in the past performance, because like how to validate the claims of any supplier that what they are doing. So we are asking for any past arrangement, partnering arrangement they have. So here they have the last is looking for a rebate program payable on monthly basis, which will be applicable when the value of goods recycled represent a positive return. So there are, even though it is not RFQ, but somehow indirectly, there is a clause for the payment terms. When this hospital is ready to pay, on what basis, right? And when they would pay. Very important thing they have written, when it would represent a positive return. So all this kind of details related to payment, related to benefit, what you are looking for, what benefits, what advantages you are looking for, what are the outcomes you are looking for, right? So for to get those outcomes, what are the possible alternatives suppliers can bring that can be kept in request for proposal. So in this case, you know, when this RFPs were asked, so this hospital received a request for proposals from three potential suppliers, and they gave some scoring based on this four section. Whatever they have claimed in their proposals, that has been tabulated, analyzed. So how to analyze, how to go for this selection evaluation, that we would do in the section when we will deal with identification and selection of suppliers. But here, you know, it is important to have an overview of the process. So in this hospital, you see here, they have gathered the data, and after providing the score, though the score was maximum for this proposal called MBD proposal, but the purchasing department or the VP purchasing, Kathy, was not happy with the scoring. Why? Because they had planned the visits to the supplier premises also. That should be the plan of selection process, selection of suppliers process. If you're not happy, if you are not sure of what is written in the proposal, right, one can go and visit the suppliers. Companies hire third party auditors to audit supplier premises. You can ask for samples if it is all together a new product. Okay, so this is the activities which purchasing companies, you know, they go for when they need to ask certain characteristics or functionalities which they cannot define clearly, hence request for proposals. However, if it was the request for quotation, all other specifications are clear, one can straightway compare the prices and provide the order.